you guys? Yes, I am wearing a bathing suit. And if you just clicked on this video, I bet you are asking, why does Kayla have on a bathing suit in the middle of winter? I know it's Los Angeles, but I don't think anyone is going swimming right now because it is about 60 something degrees outside. If you live in California, you know that basically means freezing. So no, I'm not going outside. The reason I have this on today is because I am talking to you guys about diets, specifically the ketogenic diet, also known as keto. I am going to try it for 1 month, 30 days, and see what my results are. So I wanted to wear this today so that you guys can see where I'm at right now. I'm about to stand up in a second, give you guys a full body view. I have this blanket on just because I feel a little weird sitting on my couch in a bathing suit in the middle of winter, and it is a little bit cold, so I'm putting this on until I stand up to show you guys my starting point. So a lot of people are hopping on this diet right now. It's a really, really trendy diet. I got interested. I have two coworkers actually who were doing it, and they, when they first started, I thought they were absolutely crazy. But as time has gone on, I think they've been doing it for maybe about 2 months now, and I have seen some crazy, crazy results from them. They both lost a lot of weight, leaned out a ton, and I was like, oh, okay, maybe this is an interesting diet. Maybe I'll give it a shot. Why not? Finish out the year, try something new, and hopefully it works, and coming into summer, I won't have to do all of the work of losing all the weight that I gained over Thanksgiving, my birthday, and I'm sure Christmas. So what is the keto diet? It is a high-fat, low-carb diet. So you are trying to eat mostly fats and pretty much no carbs at all. So it's like mostly fats, then some protein, I think like 75% fat, 20-something percent protein, and then like 5% carbs, whatever that math comes out to be for the protein. So the goal is really to consume as few carbs and sugar, which is a carb, as possible. So you're cutting out all processed carbs, so breads, pasta. You don't want to eat starchy vegetables, so no potatoes, fruit, trying to cut out as much fruit as possible, the sugars. So really all you're left to eat is fat, protein, and vegetables that grow above the ground. So what the diet does is when you cut out those carbs and fuel your body mostly with fats and protein, it forces your body to utilize those as its fat burning sources. So you're no longer using glucose, which is coming from the carbs and the sugar that you are consuming. You're burning your ketones. So the liver converts fat into ketones, and your body then uses that for energy. So the keto diet basically just makes your body a really, really, really efficient fat burning machine, targeting your own fat sources for energy, and it's not supposed to target your muscles, because that's also a concern. When you cut out too many calories, then your body starts targeting not only your fat, but also your muscle. And I don't wanna lose any muscle, I only wanna lose fat. So the keto diet is supposed to help your body target its own fat sources and become very, very efficient at burning that. But it does have a lot of other benefits. It's supposed to be really good for your heart, lowering cholesterol levels, lowering insulin. So this is gonna be a really, really challenging diet for me, because if you know me, you know I have the biggest sweet tooth in the entire world, and I can't go like a day without eating something sweet. It's really a wonder that I don't weigh 300 pounds. So that's definitely gonna be the biggest challenge for me. I love bread. I always say that carbs are my favorite food whenever anybody asks me, but I can do without bread. It's not as hard to cut out. I don't even buy it. I never have it in my house, and I rarely eat pasta. So that part's not gonna be so much of a challenge for me, but definitely the sugars. I love potatoes, I love mashed potatoes, baked potatoes, sweet potatoes, any type of potatoes I love. So that's definitely gonna be a struggle, but I wanna try it out for you guys. So I weighed myself this morning. This morning I weighed 33.8 pounds. So I'm gonna do weekly weigh-ins, see where I'm at, let you guys know how the diet's going. I'm gonna chronicle every day so you guys can see, you know, the challenges that I have, and you know, what's going through this, what's it gonna be like, and what you can expect if you go on to the keto diet. Here's my starting point. Well, I'll let you guys know how everything is going, and yeah, follow me along on this journey, and then decide if the diet is right for you. All right, so here's what we look like to start off. I feel a little ridiculous right now standing in front of my Christmas tree in a bikini, which is, by the way, this is my first Christmas tree ever in my entire life. I've never had a real tree, so I'm very excited about this. But I just want you guys to see what I look like so that we can see together what really changed, what changes actually happened. Did I really lose any fat? Did I lean out? Do I look the same? Let me fix my wedgie. You can just see where I start now. side view, and back view.
Close up on my abs, because I think this is where we're gonna notice the most change there, and then maybe my back, if you might, I don't know, maybe in here or something. And I guess the side view. So any changes we might notice are probably gonna come from this general area, or maybe here, I don't know, but I just want you guys to be able to see what I look like so we can really get a gauge of how well this diet works. So everyone wish me luck on this. I'm about to head to my friend's birthday party, so this is gonna be my first real challenge, because I'm sure there's gonna be lots of sweets and cookies there, and I'm not gonna be able to eat any of them at all. So everyone wish me luck. But yeah, we'll check back in a week.